love these nights because they're all about lifting up the King. They're all about making room for the Holy Spirit. They're all about giving glory to His name. Amen? And we also, today is, of course, tonight is worship night. But today has also been a very special day for us as Kingsway College kicked off. Come on, let's thank the Lord for Kingsway College. And I'm gonna invite Pastor Tim, who's the director of our Kingsway College, and Bethany, Pastor Bethany, to come up along with all of our Kingsway College students. And I want them to share a little bit with you about Kingsway College. And just to really take in what God is doing in and through this group. It's amazing.
Come on, come on. Guys, if you will, yeah, just come on and line up here. So today was orientation, and we had a phenomenal time just gathering, getting together, and I'm telling you, the glory of God was so thick. We had plans, but how many of you know He has greater plans? And this house is all about the Spirit, right? Follow the leader. What's His name? Jesus, Holy Spirit. We follow Him wherever He would go. And so there's just been such glory. And even in our time and hearing the stories from different ones of what God has done and how God brought them to this place, it was just phenomenal. We were getting wrecked. I mean, we were crying, we were laughing, we were clapping, we were rejoicing. It truly was heaven on earth. And as we wanted to start our orientation out, we started off in our upper room, in our prayer room. Right? Amen. And so as we were there, and we were just sharing, all of a sudden the spirit of prayer hit the place. And we just started groaning and travailing and just worshiping the Lord and crying out. And the Lord began to tell us that this has been a waiting room that has turned into a delivery room. And now it's time to behold everything that you've been hoping for, praying for, and believing for. So we are in for the time of our lives, for the ride of our life. And we are so glad to be able to do that with you and to do that here. Amen. So look out, Birmingham. Look out, world. Here comes some King's kids. Come on, somebody. Can you give God a shout of praise? I dare you to stand to your feet and thank God for what He's doing in these students right here, right now. Yeah, this has been a long time coming. And we're here. I woke up this morning and my wife looked at me and she said, it's delivery time. Amen. So what we want you to do is, church, friends, family, we want you to stretch your hands toward these students. And pastor's going to lead us in just a prayer as we are launching them into this year of great glory, incredible wonder, and higher levels than anyone knew was possible. Amen. Amen.
This is going to be one of those prayers that it doesn't just get on them, it's going to get on y'all. Amen. I want to tell you, listen, in Habakkuk 3:4, it says, when the Lord stretched forth His hand, lightnings were released because there the power was hidden. And I believe there's something about this pioneer class that is going to unlock a hidden power in this city. It's going to unlock a greater glory. And there's something about the hunger and even the honor for the person of the Holy Spirit that is unlocking in our house. So Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord, as we pray for each of these students right now, God, Lord, we say, come Holy Ghost, come Holy Ghost, come Holy Ghost. Father, we invite You right now to do something beyond our imagination, exceedingly abundantly greater than what we thought possible, God. God, we thank You, Lord, that this would not just be any year. It would not just be a year, but it'd be the year, the appointed time of glory, God. We thank You for commissioning. God, we thank You that they're not waiting for graduation, for activation, but God, You have started something in them now. God, we thank You for new anointings, greater authority, revelation, wisdom, insight, and understanding. God, we invite all of the resources that heaven has to give to this class and through these people right now to be released in Jesus' name. Lord, the angels, the finances, the revelation, the glory, God, the glory, God, the glory, God, the glory, God. Come on, let's really begin to pray. Come on, listen, begin to pray in the Holy Spirit. Can you do that? Come on, let's all just begin to pray in tongues. Can we do that right now? Come on, just begin to stir yourself up. Come on, this is an act of worship right now. Come on, this is a cry of Birmingham right now. It's unlocking destiny. Lord Jesus, Pastor Tina, come up with me. Pastor Tina, come. Hey, 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 hey. God, we thank You. worship team, if you can, just those of you who are not plugged in, just come and just start laying hands on these guys. Listen, there's such a grace of worship on these guys as we were hearing their story, and so many of them, what brought them to Kingsway and what God has been stirring in them. There's an uncapping of a worship well that is going to be released in and through these radical worshipers. There's going to be new sounds, new sights, new lights that are released. And we've got even more students. We've got students that are on the way to the meeting now. We've got students who are out of town for the weekend. And so you're going to continue to meet more and more students over the next couple of weeks. Jesus. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, right now. Oh, Jesus. What we have, we give you. 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 Come on, come on, Jesus, right now. Jesus, right now. Right now, right now. Jesus. More, 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 more. More Holy Spirit. More Holy Spirit. More Holy Spirit. Uncap the wells. 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 All of creation is groaning for the sounds of these sons and daughters. All of creation is groaning for the sounds of these sons and daughters. Steve and Suzanne Lemmy, you guys come on up, begin to pray with us. Steve and Suzanne are serving like fathers and mothers in the school. They're part of our instructors and our advisor team right now. Come on, just begin to release, begin to release, begin to release. You, there is a glory that is about to hit this place. Even as we're listening to the stories and the testimonies and the journeys upstairs today and just celebrating the leading of the Lord in each other's life, you can feel a glory beginning to break out. It was like the whole room, the whole building began to vibrate. And Father, right now, God, I ask, Lord, that even what's beginning in these students, whoa, Lord, that it would not be limited. I want to tell you this. Listen, how you receive determines what you released. And there's something that God is wanting to release to every one of us. And when we begin to celebrate what God is releasing to someone else, it makes room for it in our life. Amen. And I want to tell you, even with the launch of this college and these students, it's not just about the college, not just about the students. There's going to be something that has opened up and uncapped for all of us. We started thinking, going, man, think about not just starting a fire on a Sunday or making room on a Wednesday, but just having a continual burn, just a continual resting place for the glory of God, just where we can continue to keep fire on the altar and wood on the flame. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, namondo ramadere de baba. Shongo ramandara ba. Hey, hey. Wow. God, I thank you, Lord, that footing would be sure. Steps would be secure. God, I thank you for their hearts. I thank you for their yeses. God, I thank you, Lord, even for what you did today, God, Lord. Lord, that it's not going to, Lord, that it's just, Lord, if you started it like that today, Lord, who knows where this class is going to go this year. And Lord, we just take the reins off the horses right now. We take the reins off the horses. Come on, it's about to get wild up in here. I'm telling you, there are Mustangs that are about to run in Birmingham again. Right now, there have been a corralled group of horses that are about to run again. And I'm telling you, they're going to be corralled no more. There's going to be a running of the horses, a running of the the horses. It's like what Jeff and Suzanne had prophesied in the dawn of Zion's glory. I see that song coming to fruition right now. I see that song being played out in our lives and in our lifetime. In our lives and in our lifetime. That we would begin to run with the horses. That we would no longer be caught up with the issues of the footmen. We would no longer be waylaid by the small things. But we begin to run with the horses. We begin to mount up with the Lord. We begin to run and begin to fly with wings of eagles. There's always something new in God on the other side of what you expect, on the other side of what you think is comfortable. And sometimes you got to pray and you got to press beyond what you think is comfortable. You got to get out of what you expected. Some of y'all thought you're going to just come and sing a couple songs tonight. Listen, we're going to encounter the King of Glory. And listen, when God gets your gates, you get his glory. He said, lift up your head, O you gates, and be lifted up as everlasting doors, and let the King of Glory come in. You see, without him having your gates, you don't see his glory. But when you give him your eyes, you give him your mouth, you give him your ears, you give him your heart, he gives you his glory. And I'm telling you, we're about to see a greater measure of God's glory in this place when we give him our gates. Whoa! Wow. Tell you what, listen, I want you to just start putting a hand on person to the left and the right. I believe that there's something that's available to catch right now. Something that's available to catch right now. Come on, how many of you want to see something that's right now beginning to spark, spread to you right now? Begin to pray for the person to your left and to your right now. Come on, begin to pray for a move of God right where you're at right now. Begin to pray for an outpouring of God's glory right where you're at right now. Come on, the days of sitting back and watching somebody else are over. These are the days of activation. These are the days of celebration. Come on, come on, give him your gate, he'll give you his glory. Give him your gate, he'll give you his glory. Give him your gate, he'll give you his glory. Suzanne Lemmy, I need your hand. Can you put on Shonda? Hand. Yeah. Father, right now. Lord, right now I speak to the pure and living water. I'm speaking a springing up and a pushing out right now, God. God, I thank you that the waters of worship are broken right now. The waters of worship are being broken right now. The waters of worship are being broken right now. And this is a season of deliverance and delivery. A season of deliverance and delivery. I call forth right now the full expression of God's amazing gift and grace in your life to begin to flow and to begin to flourish without limits. Come on, I feel it's a word for everyone. The lower you go, the higher he'll take you. There are realms of his spirit that he wants to bring us up into that he cannot bring us up into unless we humble ourselves before one another. Oh God, Lord, release a groan that would unlock a city. 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 Yeah.
release a groan that would unlock a city. Release the sounds of sons. Release the sounds of daughters. The city is crying out. Shambaramamba. Jesus. Kamba Shungaramando. Come on.
If you want this fresh hunger, come to the front. If you want a fresh spark of God, if you say, I need to be moved like these students are being moved right now. I need God to do in me what he's doing in them. I want to break out of my casual, complacent, comfortable Christianity, and I want to break in to what God has for me. I want to break through the sound barrier. Stephen, let me come up here. Listen, it's fitting on worship night for us to break through the sound barrier. Just talk to us about the sound barrier. Listen, come one, come all. By coming up, you're saying you want more. By not coming up, you're saying I'm good where I'm at. I've got enough. Amen. I don't know about you, but I'd run through the wall like the Kool-Aid man. Amen. I feel the spirit of the Kool-Aid man coming on me. Hallelujah. You better run through a wall. Because what's going to happen is we're going to break a sound barrier tonight. And I'm telling you, these students have something to release over you. In a moment, they're going to release a groan. They're going to release a shout. And I believe when they release that groan and they release that shout, that what God is doing in them and what he's put on them is going to get on you. And if you're hungry and if you're open, it'll get in you.
Oh, show, Heavenly Father. Oh, Heavenly Father. Oh, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Lord. You know, I know that people are waiting. They've been crying out. They've been waiting for years and years and years. And you've been praying and you've been hoping and you've been believing and you've been speaking and you've been waiting and you've been crying out. But it is God's time now. It is about surrender. It is about your trusting him. Just trust in him. It is nothing that you can do. It is nothing that you've done. It is nothing that you've missed in a prayer. It is nothing that you could have done or should have done. It is now. Because the God of the universe, your heavenly Father, wants to just love you and invade you and come into you and minister to you and heal you and make you whole, to fill you. Just surrender to trust him. And I speak out, it is time to go to the other side. It is time to break through. I am sick and tired of waiting, and I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. And we are going through to the other side. And I trust you, Father. I don't care what's happened. I don't care what I didn't do. I don't care what I should do. I trust you. I trust you. And you have all of me. And I pray that the Holy Spirit consumes you and invades you and heals you in ways you do not even understand. And we cover it all in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Father. Cool. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. When it shakes, when you're shaking and you're getting close and it shakes and it hurts, you're getting close. You're getting right at the point where you break through to the other side. You break through where it's smooth. You break through. Use your voice. Use your voice. Cry out and say, I want more. I want more. I want more. More. Jesus. 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 More. More. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Wow. 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 So this is day one. Kingsway College, hallelujah. Listen, there's a glory that I don't want any of these students to step out of. So instead of coming together, I'm just going to, those who are able and are responsive, I'm going to invite you, when I count to three, to release a shout from your inner man, to release a sound from the strength of God on the inside, to begin to uncap that hidden river, that well that's on the inside of you. And those of you Those of you who are up front saying, listen, I want this. I want more. I want more of God. I want to be hungry again. I want the first love. I want my first love fire to be rekindled. I want to be lovesick for Jesus again. I want him to be the first thing I think about and the last thing I think about. I want him to be the focus of my days. I'm going to encourage you, just as they shout, take a deep breath. Jesus breathed on the disciples and said, receive the Holy Spirit. And as he told them to receive, I want to listen, if Jesus blew on me and said, receive, I'd go, I'd take everything he had. Amen. And if we're comfortable with what we've got, that's all we'll ever get. But I don't know about you, I signed up for more. And not only do I want more, I want it all. I want everything that God has for me. I want everything that God has for you, Taylor Gallman. I want everything that God has for every single one of us, for this city, for our families. We're not going to settle for anything less than the fullness. I'm going to ask Pastor Jeff to come up with me as we begin to release this sound, because I believe that he has something of a sound to release with these students as well. We've been groaning over this city these past few weeks in intercession and worship. And there's something that this man of God is carrying right now, has a groan of intercession, and it's a groan of glory that I believe is you've not heard the true sound come out of this man yet, but it's coming. There's something bubbling up right now that is a new oil. It's a fresh oil. It's a new sound. And it's not just coming out of him. It's going to come through him and unlock something in every one of us. Amen.
Thank you. Father, we just thank you tonight, Lord. Thank you for the anointing that breaks every yoke. Thank you for the anointing, God, that comes and releases us into the realm of destiny that you've called us to, God. Lord, I thank you that every person in this room has a sound. Thank you that every single person in this room has a destiny. I thank you that every person in this room are ambassadors of the kingdom of heaven. And I say right now, every person under the sound of my voice, heaven come right now. Kingdom come, will be done. Kingdom come, will be done. On earth, on earth, on earth, in every heart, in every vessel. Hey, come on in and shout to the Lord tonight. Hey, hey. Jesus, Jesus, thank you, God. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, God. We thank you, Holy Spirit. There's great destiny in this room tonight. And I just see just mantles being picked up. New leg of a race opening up to you tonight. I believe we're about to take our city for the kingdom of God like Birmingham has never been taken before. And I would say that as much as today has been a fresh start for all of our students, it's an invitation for you as well. Today is a brand new start. It doesn't matter who you are. I'm telling you, the enemy has tried to make you feel through whatever way that you're insignificant, that you don't matter, that you don't count. And heaven is screaming, no, you do matter. Your voice does matter. There's something in you that only you can release. And so I invite you tonight, even as we enter into worship, just know that your voice has value. And release it tonight. Hallelujah.
On the count of three, I want you to release that inner groan. We've already released a shout that uncapped the well. The shout uncapped the well, but now it's time to release the river. Now it's time to release the water. On the count of three, Kingsway College students, I want you to release a groan and a sound from the place of encounter that you're in right now. And those of you who are here, I want you, whatever that looks like, if it's an inhale, if it's a shout with them, but I listen, there is something to be caught tonight. Amen. One, two, three. Yeah! Catch it! Catch it! Catch the wind! Catch the sound! Catch the moment. Catch it. Catch the moment. Become the movement. Catch the moment. Become the movement. Let's worship. Come on, in this place right now, in this place of hunger, let's begin to go back into worship and let's press in even further into the presence of the Lord. There's going to be waves of the doings and the movings of God tonight. How many of you are ready to dance with the Holy Spirit? Amen. Let's see what the Holy Spirit wants to do and where He wants to take us. Amen.
Thank you so much for taking your time to join with us for one of our most recent services here at Kingsway Church. Again, we pray that you enjoyed your time viewing this video, and we invite you, if you're watching this on YouTube, click the subscribe button so you can stay up to date on newly uploaded content. If you're watching this on one of our social media platforms, we encourage you to like and share this video with your friends. And if you're watching on our website, kingswayal.com, we ask that you send us an email at info@kingswayal.com. Let us know where you're watching from and how this service impacted you. We bless you.